look, it will move or synchronize based on our selection here. I will select first record, then next. Now I will show you how to make synchronize forms. Now I will use this one. This is our mini store exercise file. I will use this one and I will take this employees table. This is the one. I will make a form just to manage our entries here. Just select this one, then click this form. Automatically it will create you a form. Then so this is our data. If we will navigate, we have existing entries. Okay, now we'll save this one. Employee. Okay, now I will copy this one. I will rename this one employee main. Then another one is other info. Info this one. Okay, employee, will remove this one because this particular form it only shown the employee personal info here. I will delete this one. I will remove this one. So I will remove this one here. Record selector. Double click only. Lock. It will remove it. So this is our main form, and this is other info. We will remove also this one. Select this one. I will remove or put here down. Then I will remove also. I will put the employee ID. Just to show you that our form, main form, and this other info synchronize this one. So I will make this one pop up. I will remove also this record selector. Okay. Now I will put here button to open our other info. So I will rename this one CLD other, and this one is other info. Now we will put code here and on current. But before that, we need to put here our option explicit, then dim str sql as string. Okay. Now we have already module. We will use this one IsLoaded in our current form current event here on current. If is loaded, this is our module, then our other info loaded other info form, this one, then our we will call our record source SQL equal select employees. This is our form from a table, rather, employees. SQL, strSQL, where, so we will put our field, which is employee ID, this one. I will copy to avoid any wrong spelling, double quote, and me then we'll put again employee ID close bracket and double quote, then close parenthesis, then double quote. Now we have issue here, double quote. Then forms, so our other info. We need to put double quote, other info, double quote, then close parenthesis, that record source. Record source, which is, this is our record source. Then do cmd dot select object ack form. Then other info, this is again our form, then false, then form again double quote, then employee main, which is our main form. This must be our focus, set focus. This is wrong, single quote, it must be double quote. Enough. Okay. I will copy this one because we will use also here to click to open our other form. Here. Else, we'll put our do cmd that. Now we will open form, then other info, then act normal. So we'll put some work condition based on our current or selected employee based on our ID here, employee ID, then and me again, we'll put our employee ID, then comma act as read only. This is just only to show the other details. Okay, here we will close our statement, if statement, then form here. Form that active control that set focus. So our active control is our employee main. So here. Okay, we'll close that one. Now we will try. This is our employee main. Then if we click this one, other info. Now we are in employee 1 here also. 1. Look, if I navigate this one to employee number 2, look what will happen for this other info. Look, it will move or synchronize based on our selection here. I will select first record. Then next block. So this is it. This is how to make synchronized form. Thank you and God bless.